Jean-Paul, good afternoon, how are you?
Good afternoon.
Here we are, and our virtual visit for our Scandinavian people here in Kenya.
Well, I say hello to the virtual visitors, at least. That's the least I can do. This is the head office. It is a very, very big shame that we have to act this way. It's a bit weird. We would have preferred, of course, to have you all here in Kenya to visit our plantations, to see our realizations, to meet with our people. It is not possible this year. It will probably be possible next year. But at least we wish to show you what is going on. We wish also to reassure you that everything is going the way it has been planned. We believe that the job has not been too much interrupted due to the COVID-19. Yes, we have challenges that should not be there. We have to find solutions, logistical and others. But in any case, the job has been done and you're all welcome for the tour.
Well, I will start by saying that Battleground Force is truly a unique company. We have been pioneering so many things. And we are proud that we are also a company that is working with an indigenous tree species, not something imported from somewhere else, and an indigenous tree species that really has so much potential and that we are realizing now. Where are we working exactly? This is a map of East Africa. Here you see Kenya, this is Uganda, Tanzania, here we have Somalia, Ethiopia, the Indian Ocean, and this is Nairobi. We started working here. Then we started working here at the coast, where you can see Lamu. Here we are. This is where our plantation of Nyongoro is situated. And then we have expanded into Uganda. We have the capital, Kampala, where we have our office. But on the ground, we are here, close to Lira, here in this part, in a district called Dokolo. And this is North Uganda. Everything which is above this lake here is North Uganda. And right now, we are also doing some prospections in Tanzania. And Tanzania is a very big country. It is the biggest of these three, as you can see. And tentatively, we can say that we have found a very good area for working here. But that is still in a phase of research, and we cannot yet say what we exactly will do and where we will do it. But we can say, yes, we're looking at it, we're looking at further expansion, so that we are truly an East African company. Now we approach the office of DMD. This is now the office where the decisions are being made. This is also the office where you are in contact with our chairman, Rino Solberg, and he is a bit in our age category.
That is true. I'm quite certain that he is missing the feeling with the operations because he is actually the person whose concept the whole Better Globe is, and it is a bit of pity he's not here. Anyway, we do the job together with the team here, the team on the sites, and we can assure you that COVID has never stopped the enthusiasm with which we plant the trees and we maintain them. By the end of the year, we will have 2.9 million trees surviving.
Wow.
That is definitely an achievement that makes us definitely the biggest mukhaw or planter in East Africa. We have big plants, we have learned a lot. We have now, since a couple of years, implemented the tree planting together with farmers, for which we have contractual farmers, about 6,000 in Kenya today, and in Uganda, where we are active and where things are going faster because, of course, we have learned from what we did here, and also the environment is different. In Uganda, we have 13,000 contractual farmers who are planting mahogany for better globe forestry.
Here we are at the site office of Kiambere Plantation. Here you see our plantation staff. They're going to introduce themselves and what they're doing.
Hi, my name is Henry Nzogona, working with PGF. Better Globe Forestry as a plantations manager in the forestry department, tasked with the role of establishing and maintaining plantations.
Hi, I'm David Moridi Nyaga. I'm in charge of site management of Kiambere Plantation. I take note on all the activities that take place at Kiambere.
Hi, I'm Christine.
Christine, how are you?
I'm fine. I'm the head of nursery, working at Better Globe Forestry. My aim is to produce mukau seedling.
I'm Daniel Mosia, head of security, working with BGF at Kiambere site. I have a team of 18 security guards who normally take care of trees that are being planted by BGF. Thank you.
I'm Jenson Mudui Mose, administrative assistant Kiambere Better Globe. I'm in charge of stores at Better Globe Forestry.
Hi, Masioko Masioko, plantation maintainer staff, working at Kiambere, doing cleaning and pruning of mukau tree.
Yes, hello, my name is Fredrick Okumu, monitoring and evaluation intern Kiambere. My main work is to monitor all the activities and ensure that the targets are achieved. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Johnson Anyumba, I'm site logistics manager Kiambere. I'm working together with the entire team to ensure that health and safety measures are looked into, and also to ensure that the supplies coming into the site are on time, to make sure that we plant more trees as there are people on earth.
Look at this. Mukau seedlings in the hundreds of thousands. A fantastic nursery. The best nursery of mukau in the world. It is dry season now. You can see it. The grass is dry, it's all yellow. The trees themselves don't have much leaf. When the rains will come, this will change dramatically and everything will become green. But this is not an easy area to work, and still we have made it to plant this species, of which the botanical name is Melia volcanci, and it is locally known under the name mukau. It is very popular with farmers because of the value of its wood and the fact that it can resist this very harsh, dry climate, including threats like termites. It is a true mahogany with very valuable wood, as valuable as the mahogany that is grown or that is growing in the rainforests of Central Africa. The motto is, apart from prosperity with purpose, mukau for a better life. And here we have the team. John.
Yes.
Now this is your team. I understand this is not the complete team.
Yes, this is just part of my well-trained agroforestry agents. I have 14 agroforestry agents that I work with. I just brought some of them. The others are busy in the field working.
So here we have then the team is leaving. Out for another day of work. Here we are again in another farm in Kitui County, where a farmer has planted a lot of mukau trees. You can see it for yourself. Very nice, very nice plantation. Yeah. This is the farmer. Yeah. Look there behind him. All these nice trees. Very well. Simon.
Yeah.
Hey, good afternoon, man. How are you?
Afternoon to you. I'm okay.
Now, how many trees have you planted here?
I planted 1,400 trees, but the surviving trees are 944.
Something like almost 70%.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. These trees look big, man.
Yeah.
Look big, really. How old are they?
The trees were planted in 2018.
So a lot of these trees are over 4 meters high, Simon. They grow very well.
Yeah, they are growing well.
This tree is easily 8 meters tall and is barely 2 years old, imagine. Commercially, Simon will make a killing here. The office. Herman. This is a rough job, man. How many of these machines do we have?
We have 8 tractors, but for mowers we have 4 mowers.
How many hectares can such a tractor and a mower do in a day?
1.5 hectares.
Now we are in the offices of KFS, which is KREP Feather Services Limited. And here is two ladies sitting here.
My name is Emma Kimani. I'm the general manager for KREP Feather Services, or KFS. The partnership and the collaboration with Better Globe started in the late 2012. Before then, KFS was not operating in the area of Mwingi. And the Better Globe, being one of the partners or collaborators that were working in that area at the time, did approach us to start a microcredit or village bank. In order to start a village bank, there are a number of costs that are required for establishment. And because this is usually given or donated to the community with the aim of creating sustainable institutions, and the foundation at the time was not there, or they could not be able to bring in all the money, we did start these operations with Better Globe, where they provided the finances to start off the FSA in terms of renovating the building, in terms of training the members, and also buying all the infrastructure development, which included even computer systems, putting up a small building to help the members to start doing the operations.
This is the village bank of Kasten, also called the Financial Services Association. Good morning, sir. How are you?
Fine, thank you, sir. My name is Nicodemus Mutemi. I am the chairman, board of directors, FSA Ngune. Our bank can be classified as a village bank. It's a community-based bank whereby members contribute their own money in the form of buying shares. And this bank was started back in 2013 in the month of May by about 400 members. And up to now, we have progressed and the members have increased tremendously. We are about 300 members right now. These are active members. When I talk of a member who is active, I mean a member who is contributing monthly is or 200 saving shillings every month. We meet once per month
so as to come and pay our loans, to come and also buy shares. We also come and contribute 200 shillings. We call it mandatory savings. This is for everybody who is an active member.
This is the FSA of Kamulongo, the only bank in town, microfinance. Now we are entering the FSA. Paul, you are running the daily operations as a manager. How many of your shareholders or your clients are linked with Better Globe Forestry?
90% of our members are also members of Better Globe Forestry, since we work in cooperation with them. We work with the groups, so most of them are also the farmers from the Better Globe Forestry.